In this video, we will create several different sized videos by using these assets and pin to edge function. We need square version, vertical story version, and one 16:9 ratio version, maybe for YouTube. First, we are going to create an empty artboard and going to artboard size options and making the size Instagram post. We will start with a square size and generate other sizes based on this square size. And then I will use this video as a background for this square artboard. Just got this amazing video from the Pexels video section. I am moving this video to the artboard by pressing Option key to duplicate. As you see, if I try to scale the video, it is scaling proportionally. But here, if I choose Fill option from the right sidebar and change the size from sides, not from edges, it will start masking the video and center it to the mask area. Now, snapping video edges to square artboard size. It's better to scale up a little bit more to be safe. Now, if I play the video, as you see, it's playing centered to the square artboard. Now, it is time to get other assets for our marketing campaign. First, I'm getting the title and centering to the artboard from the align section. And then getting the logo to the top and centering horizontally to the artboard again. Maybe it needs to be a little bit smaller. Then we have a description text, putting it just below the title and again centering. And finally, I'm getting the call to action text to bottom and centering to the artboard. Now we are done with the design. It is time to use the pin to edge feature to decide the element positions and generate different sized artboards with same concept. I am selecting the logo and clicking on the plus icon in the pin to edge section. Now I have enabled the pinning for this logo object as centered and top. The title text and want it to be on center. Same for the description text. But for the call to action, I will choose the bottom. Already when you select the items, automatically you will see best possible positions for pinning. Lastly, I am choosing the video on the background and choosing scale to scale option. This way, whatever my artboard size, it will always cover the background. Now the pinning is done. We defined which item will stay where when we change the size. Pressing Option key and making a new copy from this artboard. Then going to right sidebar and changing the artboard size to Instagram story. As you see, the logo stays on the top, title automatically came to center, and the call to action stays in the bottom. Now, if you need to change the video mask, be sure fill option is active, simply resize the video and center it. Now, our video is ready with same concept in square and vertical format. Literally no effort and in no time. If you want to make any size for your artboard, you can also do that by just changing the size from the edges. Again, create a copy from the square artboard and create a 16:9 ratio video. Maybe you want to use this version for a YouTube ad. But here, the video is not centered as I want. Just choosing the video, being sure it's on the fill option, and changing the size. Now everything is centered and looks good. If you want to make them perfect and generated results needs more work to be done, you can later adjust their positions or size as you want. You can also use pin to edge feature for animated objects. This way, generating still or animated content is so easy without repetitive work. Follow the link in the description and experience yourself now.